Overwatch League Season 2 is off to an amazing start, with so many great plays and moments that we just had to recap the best. Today, we're going to take a look at the top 25 moments from OWL Season 2, opening week. My name is Nate, and welcome to Blizzard Guides.
Thanks, guys. I got Dafran here on the floor. Everybody has been chanting his name. We saw him pop off on Torb early, which is a great way to start off the season. You guys went 4-0, which is an even better way to start off the season. This is your first time on the Overwatch League stage, so this is a huge moment. Do you have anything you want to say to your fans?
With the help of Twitch Prime, I merely managed to pop off.
Well, that's all we have here, so back to you guys.
Well, there we go. Everybody's just, you know, too hype in the arena. Linkzr, however, going to find the first kill. Envy going to be taken down now. Roki! We saw this from him at the World Cup in Incheon. This man is out of control. Gets another shot there on the aid under a little bit of fire. But oh, he gets him mid-sleep dart. He didn't even hit the ground yet.
Nope, not even going to let him touch it. Let's take a look at this opening shots here we saw from Linkzr. He goes under pressure, pulls back, then is able to turn around, identifies Ivy right in the head there. Going to get the shot on Roki there. Flyby.
This man's tracking is just beautiful. It heralds their push forward. So Soul take a Bjorn step back. He's the transcendence coming out of J-Hawk. OG is down, and Unko doesn't go for his transcendence here. He chooses not to use it until very late. And it's far too late now.
Oh! Okay! I was wrong!
Successful, right? I mean, a lot of the times the supports on Soul Dynasty were just so worried about keeping the tanks alive. That is filthy, dude. As, no,
I should lie.
Look, with J-Hong.
Shanghai coming in with a lot of ultimates themselves. Nice surge shadow through the middle of everything from Youngjin. Waiting for it, they're gonna get caught up in the Graviton Surge. Responding with that Earth Shadow.
Oh! That is a boop, and I have to set up that 4-kill for Rhea, and Rhea just giving the uppercut to Zenyatta in the end.
He has returned to the fray.
But they still want to go outside. They still want to chill in space. All right, I feel this. So again, they are really adamant about pushing from the outside, which is not a common strategy, by the way, ladies and gentlemen. It kind of puts you at a disadvantage. Raw says, no, I'm going to send them straight back out in the airlock. It's like a grisly death in every space movie ever.
No,
Raw's getting all the credit for those as well, because he hit him with the final, with the Primal Rage. Excuse me. Looks really good on the kill feed, but it'll
be 18th season here. They're looking to change all of that with this roster that stays mostly the same. They filled the trace.
Okay, sees the trap.
Fissure's dropped from the high ground, so you needed somebody to contest.
Orisa's shield broken. Dalnus is still relatively durable. Fissure has to... Oh, Jaxter!
Oh, no.
That's the pick! That's the golden shot! And he's got another one! AKA is back! 3 kills with the Widowmaker! And the Dallas Fuel have found the key!
Valkyrie's up for Coma, but he's got to stay alive.
Okay, Stitch now in position. This is the toughest part for the Dragons. They just need to be stable here. Look at the dust!
Blanket from behind, the Deadeye coming down! The Pharmacy Cop is right out of there, digging Coma. Both say goodnight. Another shot, the headshot there on the DM. Takes him out, the hit onto Gregory in midair. And in style, Vancouver Titans glide into the finish on Dorado.
Starting off first, please get on your feet and put your hands together for the Philadelphia Fusion. Leading the charge, sports fans will recognize one of Philadelphia's most attractive faces. It's him, it's Gritty.
Valentine's Day is off to a good...
Mobility is the name of the game for New York Excelsior's composition here. It's hard for Washington Justice to commit into a fight when they're at half health.
Mirage just right here in the gateway. Whoa, Libero! Get knocked to the side, will be taken down in the Antihana.
The attacking team means you have to start over. And, you know, you say 15 seconds, that's a bit conservative. I'd say we're really looking at like almost 30 here because you got to get reset. Bumper's
Bumper sinking in from the back. The Shatter comes down. Good night, Huxall. Follows up, gets Gamsu. This guy has been doing this for ages, and still, people don't look both ways.
Look at the abilities right there, and Hangzhou once again coming on top.
Yeah.
DM needs to get a good stick here. Not going to be able to demech anybody quite yet. Still looking for opportunities. That's a nano boosted Reaper with a Death Blossom.
Right. Here we go. He's going to try to come in. Die, die, die. He gets two. Got to be falling as well. And Shanghai Dragons
they waited till the last second, but they just have done it here. Looks like they will. Hangzhou Spark couldn't hold long enough, and Shanghai Dragons are still alive in this series.
They'll pick up their first map win. Still need to get two more if they want to take this one home.
It means that Washington Justice has to be very wary about how they move around this corner. It's just not the shatter itself, the threat of the shatter. That's the most important part of this. He's backing away now.
A bomb that opens things up, trying to give them some space. Graviton Surge going to be coming through from New York, locking them up. No kill, maybe on the other shatter! On the side!
No way!
Quadra kill! Mekko decimates their lineup!
And it's the threat of the shatter that they do not respect. They come in there, they get grabbed. He comes around the side and sets up for the big bomb there.
It's difficult to deal with, you know. The Winston in your face, the D.Va on one side. Oh, by the way, Sombra invisible running around.
Oh, Master's in trouble. That's an angel grounded. Carpe looking for Urstu, who now just needs to stick behind the lighthouse, but a Mercy down is huge, making two supports. Again and again, Carpe delivers.
It's going to be the rally coming in from Baze. Spark tries to hold it. Both teams popping that extra armor from the Pegida. Waiting for the angle to try to get aggressive here. Oh, Kareem! He gets his Graviton Surge eaten by Rhea. And now space returns. Oh, and Rhea grabs three with the self-destruct. And Izayaki can just float there and cry because that Transcendence does not save you from that D.Va ultimate. That's going to be Spark taking the fight, and they will take the first point on Busan.
This grab. Yeah, does he find it? The Matrix has been used, and as soon as it wears out, boom, chucks it. But unfortunately for him, not quite the results, perhaps, that he was looking for. Not a monster one. They're going to back off and reset, so it's the same result in the end. And whoa. We're going to get a grab going through here. They might have overextended the charge. They may get punished. Sound barrier used, and everybody from the Hunters rallying on the point.
You took a step too far into the wrong neighborhood, son, and the Hunters are going to take this one. Last second. There it is!
Into a position where he could do massive damage.
Yep. Like, they're gonna be trying to get in behind the enemy squad. Oh, gets tagged up quite a bit. Teleporter straight in over onto the point. There they go. Just the one tick is all that they need.
No way.
Charge. RCK makes his way over. They're still taking this one up. Somebody's gonna drop down. They finally managed to do so. But OG, he is so very low. They move up the point for just a second. And San Francisco Shock will take it.
An incredible Symmetra strategy. They teased the Orisa cop. They knew that we're gonna be running the Orisa defense.
Oh, gets hacked though. Tracer in a lot of trouble. There's a kill. Youngjin does get the equalizing one. Onto Cosby. Gangri comes in, drops a minefield.
Whoa!
Double kill from that minefield. Pops Rhea out of the mech as well. You don't want to step there.
Man.
Oh, wow. That's a great push by the Shanghai Dragons.
They crushed it, man.
EMP coming down onto four.
Yeah, we'll see, man. Swapping over the Hammond is no smite. He does get tagged. Saves life barely long enough to buy time for Rhea to come back in. So Spark.
They use to engage in that fight. You know, you get a few players weak. You see, you know, teams just kind of bouncing back and forth. Is that really like a main healer on any of these compositions when you do this? So, be the Graviton Surge. Transcendence comes out. Self-destruct as well. Sound barrier here from Philly as well.
Poco tries to Earth Shatter there, but he's actually knocked into the air. He can't land it.
Oh!
Poco is back in the building, ladies and gentlemen. Not a moment too soon either.
At this, and they have no ultimates to speak of.
Really good delay, self-destruct, and the sound barrier available from the Houston Outlaws. But oh no!
They do not touch the point.
They just don't touch it!
And you know, this is a tough moment where you're trying to get in there and buy the most amount of time, but it was a pretty futile situation either way. You know, if they do touch it, it's not that that's gonna save them. That was a one game.
As they charge forward back over onto A, right in front of the spawn to gatekeep them. Nice right click as well.
Oh, finishing blow there. Onto Closer as well. Gonna send him back to the spawning room, or rather, back to Hero Select, I suppose. He was already there in the spawn. It will respawn. Lost a little bit of ult charge, passive charge from that as well. He's only at 35% at the moment.
AKM in the meantime. Trying to get a back cap coming through. Oh boy, the double kill off the pin from Super.
And it's just a massive, it's a massive bio grenade from Architect as well. But getting into position to duel the Widow is not going to be easy.
Yeah, let alone he had that double threat of the far as well. Gets a couple shots in. Okay, Ding gonna be taken down. Kulba, can he get the rest? It's gonna be the question. Banning the hammer. I think Kulba's gonna be looking for it. He's got the Valkyrie popped.
Ups 200, a little bit of fire. OT rolling through. Coma gonna be taken down right as that res comes in, and Sitch scoops up the kill, ding, but right back into the grave. Now pushing forward halfway, headshots out of the up, he gets the double tap! Sitch takes some hell with his signature McCree! Now Gamsu dead, and Vancouver Titans will be able to push into A right at the last second.
Some crazy, like, obviously these fights go so long with three tanks and three supports, but we have seen some massive, like, grab and self-destruct combos, and then also a lot of counter shatters, like when, I know, whether you're in a grab and then you shatter towards the end or whatnot, but, man, some sick play here.
We saw, like, the Valiant sort of trend to the back.
So you kind of almost have like two Zarya's out on the field, except like Shervor can get charged up much faster. So, you see, that's going to be the Sim ultimate, so that's the Photon Barrier as they push onto the point.
I mean, look at how powerful it is. The Soul Dynasty, if they want to interact with the Gladiators at all, they have to step forward. They might just be forced to wait this out or wait for Fisher, and that seems to have been the plan. Fisher comes in, gets his Zarya bubble pretty much instantly, but there's a Transcendent in over the fight. J-Hawk responds, gets one of his own. Fisher's down, tank battle won by the Gladiators. Now the charge on out, and well, look at J-Hong being forced away from his team. They can't benefit from the healing. Flatter falls flat as the charge connects, and J-Hong's all alone. The Gladiators, the Symmetra play, the dream is real.
Anyway, let me know what your favorite moment was in the comments down below. Tell us what you're excited to see in week 2 as well. If you guys want to see more content just like this, get subscribed and notified so that you never miss an upload. And if you guys want to join the Blizzard Guides community, you can follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and Discord. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Have a nice day. My name is Nate, and this was Blizzard Guides.